Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at some belt calculations. Now this is for a pulley system. As an example here, we've got the induction motor connected via a belt through these two pulleys as the driving force for this centrifugal fan here. Now this is typical you might find in maybe an AHU in your building. You'd also have this set up on some on pumps and also some conveyor belts. A lot of machinery in manufacturing as well. So they're fairly commonplace. So let's do some maths on those. Now the two things we'll be calculating in this video are the belt length, so how long is or does that need to be, and also the distance between the two pulleys, which we're just going to reverse that calculation to find that. Now these calculations are mainly for existing installations, but you could also put it towards your design if you want to calculate what the length needs to be of the belt if you already know what the distance between the two are and the size of the pulleys. The second part, the distance between the pulleys, is more if you already know what length belt you need and also you know the diameter of both the pulleys, but you're not sure exactly what the distance should be between them. So that calculation will calculate that for you. Now I just want to point out that these calculations, the figure you get from these, it may vary slightly from the real world scenario, but this is the best calculation that you can perform to get the most accurate figure. So anyway, let's jump into the calculations. So first of all, we'll have a look at the belt length. What length does this belt need to be? And in this example, we're going to look at the belt between the induction motor and also a centrifugal fan in an AHU. So we want to know this, the belt length, and that is the length of this belt in total. Now we already know the size of the pulley, either from the manufacturer's data or we can go out into the building and actually measure this. And remember, pulley one is always going to be the largest pulley you have, and you'll see this as we go through the calculation shortly. We also have pulley two, and we know the diameter of this pulley as well. Again, this is taken from manufacturer's data or measured. And we also know the center distance between these two pulleys. Now, I've used a couple of symbols here. So we've got this symbol here, which this is widely used for engineering. And this means diameter. So the distance from one side of the other to the other of the circle here. And also the center distance is usually formed by C-C, meaning center to center. So the difference between that center and that center, or the measurement between these two. Now the formula we're going to use to calculate this is shown now on the screen, and it looks quite long, but it's not as complex as it might first seem. I've also color-coded the numbers here, as many as possible, just to make it that little bit easier. And I've also split the screen into metric and imperial, so whichever units of measurement you're using, you can follow these through. So first of all, if we write the formula out and then drop these numbers in, taking the 207.874, etc., etc., and we drop those numbers into the first formula. So first of all, we'll calculate the brackets. We're just going to minus these two here, as well as multiplying these two brackets or the figures within them, and we're also going to add these figures here as well. Now for the next part, we're just going to square this top bracket here on the top of the division there, or the numerator. Then we'll just do the division between these, and obviously as these are, I've forgotten to put inches on these ones, but as these are the same units, they just cancel out and become a ratio or a percentage. Then we'll just multiply these first two numbers together, bring this down to this last line here. And then we just simply add all these numbers up together, and you can see that the length of this belt is going to come out at 1675 millimeters in length, or 65.96 inches. So we'll just write those down and color code it for later use. And that's it. So it's not as hard as it looks. It's actually fairly simple. So for the next part, we're going to do the center distance, and this is going to be metric first. You'll see in just a second that it's actually quite long-winded, and I wasn't able to fit both metric and imperial on this one. So if you're looking for the imperial version, then you can skip through the video slightly, but otherwise stick with us now and we'll look at the metric. So in this calculation, we need to know what the distance is between these two pulleys. We already know what pulley 1 diameter is, also what pulley 2 diameter is, and we also now know the belt length, but we do not know what the distance between these should be. So you can see from this formula here that this one's a bit more complex. Don't worry if this scares you and you're not so hot in your maths. We're going to go through it all anyway, step by step, so let's jump into it. So the first part is obviously to drop these numbers in. They're all color-coded, so you should be able to just drop these in from your example. If you're following in from home, then just write these all down as so. So first of all, you'll want to tackle the brackets first. So you can see here, we're just going to take these two away from each other. Then we'll also do the same for this bracket here, except we'll add these two together. And it's the same for this bracket here. Next, I'm just going to square the contents of this bracket here to get this final figure there. Then we're going to multiply 4 by 1675, and we're also going to do 6.28 multiplied by 300 millimeters to get these two figures there. Then still within the brackets, so we're going to take this figure from here to get this number there. Then we just square that figure there to get this one. And also multiply the 32 by 10,000 to get 320,000. We then just subtract these numbers here to get this one here. Then we need to take the square root of this number here to get this number there. And you can see I've just run out of space, so I'm going to bring the calculation up to here. So if we add those two numbers together, then we'll get 9598.66 over 16. And if we do the division of those, then we get 600. So the center distance between these two pulleys needs to be 600 millimeters. If you are going to do this, I would highly recommend you did it by Excel. It's a lot easier and quicker. But should you need to do it in exam, this is the calculation for that. So there you go. It's not so not as hard as it looks. Now for this calculation here, we're going to calculate the distance between the two centers again, same as the metric version we just did. But this time we're going to do it in imperial units. So this is the formula we need to use here. It's exactly the same as the metric. And it is a bit of a slightly more complex than the first calculation we did in this video. But don't worry if this scares you and you're not so hot at your maths. We're going to walk through each part step by step. So first of all, we just want to drop those numbers in. So just replace these colored letters with the number that you've got from your example. And you just fill all of these out. Leave all the numbers that are in black. They are constants. So first of all, you'll want to calculate anything within the brackets. So you can see this one here, we've just subtracted the numbers. This one here, we've added them. And this one here, we've also added them together to get this bracket here, and this bracket here. And this bracket here is ready to be squared. So I've just done that in this one here. Then we can go through and do the other brackets. So we can do 4 multiplied by 65.96 to get this figure. 6.28 multiplied by 11.81 to get this figure here. We can exactly the same for this set here. And in the next line, we're going to just subtract these two numbers here to get this one there. Then we can subtract these two numbers to get this one, and we can also square this number here to get this one there. Oh, and also multiply these together. So then we'll just subtract these two numbers from each other to get this one here. Then we take the square root of this number here to get this one there. As you can see, I've run out of space at the bottom here, so we're just going to continue it up here. So we just add these two numbers together to get 378.03 inches over 16. And if we do the division of the two, then we get 23.6 inches. So the center distance between the two pulleys is going to be, in this case, 23.6 inches. Again, as you can see, this figure, how we calculated this, it was not as complex as it might have first looked. And if you want to do this calculation, I would highly recommend that you did it through Excel or a program like this, some sort of spreadsheet, rather than by hand. But if you're going into an exam, then you'll want to do it like this. You can obviously speed it up a little bit, but I've just put out a long form so everyone can see how we got to those figures. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this has helped and you've enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and share. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. Also, don't forget to check out our website, theengineeringmindset.com. And once again, thanks very much for watching.